Good morning and welcome to the first International Space Station update for 2012. Currently on board, the crew of Expedition 30 is continuing their full six-man utilization. That crew is being led by NASA astronaut Commander Dan Burbank, there in the middle left, and he is joined by Russian cosmonauts Anton Shkaplerov and Anatoly Ivanishin behind him. And on the right side, the three recent additions to Expedition 30, who docked back on December 23rd, NASA astronaut Don Pettit, Russian cosmonaut Oleg Kononenko, and European Space Agency astronaut Andrei Kuipers. The crew awoke today at about midnight Central Time and then had their daily planning conference where they discussed the day's activities with controllers on the ground. Starting off the crew, Commander Burbank is spending much of his day today installing the EPIC processor card, EPIC standing for the Enhanced Processor and Integrated Communications. This is a fairly intensive process that has been going on for over a week now, and he'll be installing the EPIC card in the Guidance and Navigation Control MDM. That'll take up about 4 hours of his day today. Then later on, he'll do some crew medical officer proficiency training. Anton Shkaplerov is spending some time with the Urigan experiment, which looks to do observations and photography and permanent monitoring of areas where natural and man-made disasters are forecasted, and also doing some stowage work on the 45 Progress vehicle, which docked back in early November. Anatoly Ivanishin is working on a joint Russian-German experiment known as Plasma Crystal 3+, which looks to study wave propagation and dispersion ratios in dust plasmas. He'll be setting up the photography and video for this, and then also doing a video recording for Russian television with Anton Shkaplerov. Oleg Kononenko will also be working on that Plasma Crystal 3 experiment, doing the comm config and then all of the setup and execution work before moving on later in the day to do some item transfer of his own from the Soyuz 29 or TMA-03M spacecraft that he arrived on the station in. European astronaut Andrei Kuipers is doing the NeuroSpat setup and experiment work today. This is a test that looks at the prefrontal brain functions and spatial cognition. And this determines the effects of the zero-gravity environment on how the brain processes everything around it. You can see him there working with Don Pettit, who helped him set that experiment up earlier today. Kuipers will also be working with the integrated cardiovascular ambulatory monitoring, setting that up. That experiment looks at cardiac atrophy, which occurs during spaceflight, and how fast it develops and any problems that it may cause. Rounding out the crew, NASA astronaut Don Pettit is doing a number of sample collections throughout the day from the Human Research Facility, and then storing those samples in the Melfi, which is the minus 80 degrees freezer, which is used to store those biological samples for later delivery and analysis on the ground. He also did that NeuroSpat setup, as you just saw with Andrei Kuipers, and then later in the day we'll be replacing a failed laptop on one of the express racks, installing a few new software applications. The crew will end their day with a second daily planning conference, going over the day's events and any get-ahead work that they have for tomorrow, before going to sleep later today at 3:30 p.m. Central Time.